Hi, everyone. I'm Steve Seldy, the director of the Biosimilars Council, which is a division of the Association of Accessible Medicines. I'm joined here today with Hillel Cohen, the executive director of scientific affairs at Sandoz. So to start, Hillel, can you tell us a little bit about yourself and your work to create awareness about biosimilars?
Certainly. Well, first, thank you very much for having me. I've been working in the area of biosimilars with Sandoz for close to 20 years now. And one of the major roles I have at Sandoz is to explain the basics, the principles of biosimilars to various stakeholders, to patients, patient groups, their healthcare professionals, and others involved in distributing biosimilars around the globe. Sandoz was the first company to develop biosimilars in Europe, in the US, in Japan. As such, we've been at the forefront of biosimilar education since then. So this is a topic that's very near and dear to my heart.
You mentioned the biosimilar approval in the EU. That first happened in 2006. Globally, since that time, how have you seen awareness about biosimilars increase or change? And why is 1 week just devoted to biosimilar education so important?
Well, it's been interesting for me to see how patient concerns and various issues have changed and evolved over time. The initial questions about biosimilars were quality. Can a biosimilar company manufacture a product to the same high quality as that of the reference products? Next question that came up was, can you extrapolate indications? Then there's a question about switching. Can an existing patient be safely and effectively transitioned from the reference biologic to a biosimilar? And more recently, people questioning, can you go from one biosimilar to another biosimilar? So as the industry has grown and the industry has evolved, the questions have changed with it. Now, we'd like to think that all of these questions have good answers. And we found when you sit down and explain in clear, easy to understand language, tailored to specific audiences, the message comes across. And this is where the Global Biosimilars Week really helps. You have multiple stakeholders engaged in explaining the basics of biosimilars using similar messages. And that's a very powerful tool.
You just covered a range of topics that are so important in biosimilar education, but to touch on some of your more recently published work covering transitioning to biosimilars and then biosimilar to biosimilar switching, what are some of the takeaways just for the broad public and then specifically for healthcare providers?
That's an interesting question. Way back in 2017 or thereabouts, people were saying the biosimilars should be reserved only for new patients, that existing patients should stay on the existing products, reference products, because there was little to no data. That had me frustrated because not only was there a little data, there actually was a lot of data. It just hadn't been collated thoroughly. So I led a team. We published a systematic review when we showed 90 studies, 17 products, 14,000 patients. And all of these studies came to the same conclusion. There was really no problem transitioning from a reference biologic to biosimilar. More recently, we've had similar comments. Well, if you're on a biosimilar, you have to stay on that biosimilar. You really can't go into another biosimilar. Again, there actually is a decent amount of data behind this, and it's been done. It just hadn't been collated. So last July, we published the first systematic review of biosimilar to biosimilar switching. We found 23 studies, four different products, around 3,600 patients, and each and every one of those studies came to the same conclusion, not a problem. Since that time, which is the December of 2021, additional four biosimilar to biosimilar switchings have come out. Again, no problem. So now it's a little over 4,000 patients. And it's sort of interesting to see that a month or two ago, the EMA, the European Medicines Agency, came out with a statement saying that there's no problem switching from one biosimilar to another. The Medicines Agency, MHRA in the UK, also updated the guidance to say biosimilar to biosimilar switching is a safe and effective clinical practice.
We had a couple real-time examples from that UK regulatory authority's announcement yesterday on the 7th to a whole range of research topics, really pointing, it seems like, to the fact that biosimilars are as safe and with no clinically meaningful differences from the reference product. Thank you for taking a little bit of time to join us here, Hillel. We appreciate your work in this space and your efforts to increase awareness about biosimilars.
Thank you very much.